Hello children, welcome back to another class of English grammar for class 4. Today we will be starting with the simple present tense from your grammar book. So let us see what a simple present tense is. A simple present tense tells us about an action, about actions that are done regularly or as a matter of habit. That means it tells us or expresses habits in general truth, repeated actions or unchanging situations, emotions, wishes, all these things come under the general simple present tense. So what are the uses of a simple present tense? We use simple present tense when we need to state a fact that is true. For example, it is hot in summer. So this is a state of fact. This is something which is true. This never changes. It is always hot during the summer season. The next is the earth travels around the sun. This is also one of the facts that never change. The earth always travels around the sun. Now the third use of the simple present tense in our sentences, that is, it expresses an action that is repeated, that is done many times, several times, or it is regular in the present. Things that we regularly do, that comes also under the simple present tense rule. So let us have a look at one or two examples that I have written to show you how we do our actions or how the actions are done in a regular base into everyday's life. I take the school bus every day. Now this is an action that is repeated every day because I need to go to school. So the next one is Rani travels to her workplace on a train. This is also an action which is repeated and it is done regularly in the present tense. So let us have a look at the third use of the simple present tense. The third use is that it speaks about habits. What habits? Some habits that we are taught. For example, she brushes her teeth twice every day. This is a habit which we are taught when we are children. So this sentence tells us, or the verb in the sentence tells us about an action that is a habit. Next, I do yoga thrice a day. This is also a habit which is inbuilt in us. Next, the fourth use of the simple present tense is to state something that is true in the present. For example, I am 10 years old. I am in class 4. Anu lives in London. These sentences show us that these things are true in the time now. Now children, let me explain the structure of simple present tense when we use it in our sentences. So we are first of all going to discuss how to write declarative sentences. Now for example, if your sentence or your subject starts with I, we, you, they, or a name, two names put together, for example like Rina and Tina, then the verb that we use does not have a S. It only has the base form or the V1 form of the verb. And then after that we write the remaining sentences. For example, I dance on the stage, we dance on the stage, you dance on the stage, they dance on the stage, Rina and Tina dance on the stage. But if our sentence or our subject starts with he, she, it, or anyone's name, for example, I have written Tina here, the verb that we use always has a S on it. And then we write the remaining part of the sentence. For example, he dances on the stage, she dances on the stage, it dances on the stage, Tina dances on the stage. Now children, let me explain how we use simple present tense while writing a negative sentence. We all know that negative sentence always contains the words like no, never, not. So let us see when our subject starts with, or when our sentence starts with I, we, you, they, Rina and Tina. These are two names put together. What do we do for the verb? First of all, we know that we have to write the base form. So the base form is written, that is dance. We also know that we have to write the word not to make it a negative sentence. Since this is the base form, what do we write? We write do. So when we write negative sentences and our subjects are one of these, we write do not. After that, we write the remaining part of the sentence. Let us see, for example, how we will read these sentences. I do not dance on the stage. We do not dance on the stage. You do not dance on the stage. They do not dance on the stage. Rina and Tina do not dance on the stage. But when we have subjects like he, she, it, or any one name, what happens to our verb? Since we are making a negative sentence, we know that the word not is to be written. Along with that, the base form. But we do not add s over here. So what do? We write the word does. And then we write the remaining part of the sentences. For example, he does not dance on the stage. She does not dance on the stage. It does not dance on the stage. Or Tina does not dance on the stage. Now children, let us learn how we use simple present tense in the interrogative sentences. So over here I have made a table, and in that I have mentioned the verb, the subject, again the verb, and then the rest of the sentence. Now let us pay attention to what we do. When we start a question and a subject is I, we, you, they, Rina and Tina, for example, names are there. Okay, what do? You start your question with do because you are using the base form of the verb and your subject belongs to one of these in the group. So what do? You start your question with do, you write your subject, you write the base form of the verb, and then you write the remaining part of the sentence and put a question mark. Let us read as one of these examples over here. So if I start my question using the using do, how does the sentence form? How does the question form? So do I dance on the stage? Do we dance on the stage? Do you dance on the stage? If you take note, I have not written an S over here because these are my subjects. But if my subjects were he, she, it, or any one person's name, I would start my question using does. And then I would use again the base form of the verb since my question starts with does. And then I write the remaining part of the sentence. So how does my question form? Does he dance on the stage? Does she dance on the stage? Does it dance on the stage? Does Tina dance on the stage? There are some more words which are generally used in the simple present tense, like often, never, always, usually. These are some words which are always used in the simple present tense. Now children, let us have a look at some of the examples and circle the simple present tense according to the rules that I have taught you. Now I have told you that when our sentence starts with I, that's our subject. When we write the verb, we do not write S in the verb. So play becomes our verb over here, a simple present tense. Next, we have Martin as the subject and sings as the simple present tense. I told you that if we use a person's name, a singular person's name, for example, Charmin ma'am, Lucy, Lucky, Nidhi, these are all names of one person. When we write the verb, we add a S to it. Again, let us have a look at the third example that I have over here. My father works in a factory. Again, we are talking about one singular person here. So the verb when we write, we add a s to it. So the verb is, this is, the verb is works. Now let us have a look at the next one. Over here we have a noun. We look at this last sentence. We have children, which is the plural form of child. Now when we write the verb, we pay attention and we write only drink. We do not add s to it. So according to the structure which I have taught you in the earlier part of the video, this is how we pick out the verbs and write them. Thank you.